हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ अमनप्रीत कौर फ्रॉम गुरु नानक देव यूनिवर्सिटी एंड आई एम अ लीगल इंटर्न एट लेक्सस एंड कंपनी। सो टुडे वी गोना टॉक अबाउट FIR। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज़ FIR? सो फर्स्ट इंफॉर्मेशन रिपोर्ट इज़ नोन एज FIR। सो इट इज़ अ फुल फॉर्म ऑफ FIR, दैट इज़ अ फर्स्ट इंफॉर्मेशन रिपोर्ट। इट इज़ मेंट टू रिकॉर्ड द इंफॉर्मेशन दैट इज़ ब्रॉट टू द नॉलेज ऑफ द पुलिस। दिस इंफॉर्मेशन वेदर रिसीव्ड इन राइटिंग और ओरली इज़ रिक्वायर्ड टू बी रिड्यूस्ड टू अ रिटन रिपोर्ट दैट शैल बी क्रेडिटेड फॉर सेटिंग द क्रिमिनल लॉ इन मोशन। सो इन केस ऑफ अ कॉग्निजेबल ऑफेंस, द पुलिस इज़ परमिटेड टू गो अहेड एंड मेक एन अरेस्ट विदाउट अ वारंट एंड कमेंस द इन्वेस्टिगेशन। On the contrary, in a non-cognizable offense, the police do not have the liberty to take either of these actions without the explicit permission of the court. So there is a prior permission needed in this case. So this position is clarified by means of section 154 and 155, which is read in section 2 of the CRPC. So then comes complaint and FIR. So people tends to mix these two concepts. The complaint and FIR are not same. There is a difference between them. So complaint refers to an appeal made to the magistrate comprising an allegation that a crime has taken place. FIR implies the complaint registered with the police by the plaintiff or any other person having knowledge of the cognizable offense. Then an FIR can be lodged by any person who has the knowledge of the commission of a cognizable offense. This power extends to the victim, a witness, and any person who knows about the facts of such commission of an offense, including a police officer himself. So he must be well aware about the facts. So other than that, FIR will remain valid and it does not lapse with time. On completion of investigation, police has to file either a charge sheet or a closure report in the court under section 173 of the Criminal Procedure Act. Till that time, the investigation is considered to be ongoing and validity being done. Then comes that we can say it is possible that after an FIR is filed, the other party, that is the accused side, may also file an FIR against the complainant. If, however, both the FIRs are registered by the police, they may decide to conduct a joint investigation resulting in a combined charge sheet, or they can also file separate charge sheets according to their as they deem fit. Then Code of Criminal Procedure in Australia deals with the registration of FIR. As stated earlier, Section 154 obligates the police to register the FIR after receiving the information. It may be oral or written, the commission of a cognizable offense. It is worth noting that the police officials have the right to arrest the accused without the permission of the magistrate in cognizable cases. Moreover, the Honorable Supreme Court in the case of Lalita Kumari versus Government of UP and others has let down certain directions for the police officials regarding the registration of FIR. So further in the case, the court stated that the police is bound to register an FIR when the information supplied to the police discloses the commission of a cognizable offense. So then comes that there may be many reasons which in some cases explain the unwillingness of a police officer to record an FIR. So it causes a certain problems in the registration of FIR. So it has been noted many times, in order to maintain a statistic or show a decrease in the crime rate of the respective area, an official may discourage a person or the family of the victim to register an FIR just to be in the good books of the politicians or some other thing. Then the police may also be hesitant to take up on investigation into the matters that have a political undercurrent. Then there could be a delay in registering an FIR, which may also discredit the evidentiary value of that. Although an FIR is not always considered as a piece of substantive evidence, however, in exceptional cases such as in dying declaration, an FIR may be considered as substantial evidence which is good enough to support the order of conviction. Then it is important to note that once registered, an FIR cannot be withdrawn either during the course of trial. Your statements in his favor shall help your friend's case of defense, and he will be acquitted or he can go for quashing of the FIR in the High Court. So the client should know that FIR can only be quashed by the High Court only. So this was all about FIR. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, put a thumbs up on this video and don't forget to like and subscribe the channel Explain. This does not solicit any promotion or advertisement. As per the guidelines of the Bar Council of India, it is for education purpose only. Thank you.